Hi guys, it's Simelsi here, so welcome to another apartment renovation. So today I'm renovating this apartment, which is located in the Fashion District of San Myshuno. This one is across the hallway from the last apartment that I did. I am completely obsessed with using the new windows that came with the Moschino stuff pack. In these apartments, I have balconies, so I wanted to do another one, and this time I wanted to do something that was kind of industrial and maybe Brooklyn inspired. I'm not too familiar with Brooklyn apartments, so I don't know if it looks like one, but either way, I wanted it to be lofty and industrial, have lots of exposed brick, and just feel really rustic and perfect for an artistic sim. And I was trying to do a different layout than I've done before in this apartment, so here you can see me messing with it. Originally, I was going to make this entire room here the living area with the kitchen, dining, you know, living room, all of that in this one area. But then I decided to move the kitchen into that little room that I created. Originally, that was going to be a bathroom, so it kind of took me a while to get exactly where I wanted to be and how I wanted it to look. But here are the new windows and the new door that came with the pack. I am absolutely obsessed. For me, they make the pack completely, along with the photography career. Now, I haven't played with it. I've heard it's pretty glitchy. Hopefully it'll be fixed, but it's something I've wanted, especially just for like storylines with certain sims that I have in my save file. Because a long time ago, maybe like 2 years or something, it's been a long time, but I built this penthouse. It was kind of in the same style, and I built it for a photographer, and I used all of the equipment that we got from Get Together. And while that works pretty well, it was a little bit limiting. So I'm excited to update that penthouse with the objects and actually give the sim that lives there the photography career. I think it's gonna be amazing because, yeah, before I wasn't really exactly sure what I was going to do. I was gonna kind of just make up their job and maybe have them be like a freelance artist and pretend that their art is photography. But now I can actually do it. So I'm so happy to include that in my save file. And yeah, either way, here you can see I am fiddling with the kitchen. I felt like it looked so strange, just kind of open in this area. So I decided just to turn this into the kitchen. And then I moved the bathroom behind the staircase later on because I definitely wanted there to be a bathroom on the lower level. Even though it's all open, basically the same room, I still feel like it's just so much more convenient to have a bathroom on a first floor and the second floor if you're going to do like a multi-story building. But here I'm just messing with the staircase, trying to plop in a tiny bathroom over here. And I think it actually comes together so nicely. It's nice and open and it's really cool and definitely has that lofty feeling that I want this build to have. And here I did want to place a garage door that came with City Living because that also feels very industrial and lofty to me. And then here I am working on the kitchen. I love the way it looks with these black appliances, the brick, and these countertops that we have from Base Game also work really nicely for this industrial feeling. I love the tops of the counters. I'm not exactly sure what you call them, but they kind of look like chopping blocks. I know there's a word for it, but it's escaping me now. But I would really like to see them maybe reuse this wood texture in like a future countertop. I think that would be really nice just with a different lower or some recolors of this one because we've had it for so long and there's only 3 swatches, but I absolutely love it, especially this one with the light wood top. It's so, so pretty. Over here next to the front door, I wanted there to be a coat rack. This coat rack was giving me such a like trouble. I was not exactly sure what color I wanted to use it in, so I changed it a few different times, and then I think I even changed it again when I was taking the screenshots. It just didn't come in the right colors, but I absolutely love it and I want to use it in here. It did come from Seasons in case you guys weren't exactly sure which pack it came with, but I thought it looked really nice. And then over here I did put a chair in the corner. I do end up moving that plant to the other side of the room, and then I used that industrial lamp that we have, I think from Base Game. Maybe it came from Get to Work, I'm not exactly sure, but you will see it here in just a moment, and I use it throughout the entire apartment. It is so cool. It's like really industrial looking. And then I use this side table over here with a few decorations up on top of it. I do place a lamp here next to this hand reference, but I move the lamp later on, and I think I place a plant there instead. Yeah, I don't know. You'll see it come together. And then over here, I do place a dining table. I wanted to use one of those that were a bit taller. But I decided to go with the shorter one because I really wanted to use some of these like industrial chairs that we have. I was trying to see if I could find some other ones because every time I go for an industrial look, I use these ones, but they are too perfect, especially with this black and the brown. I know this is very similar like in color scheme to the last apartment that I did, but even though they're a very similar color scheme with like all the rich darks, like the browns and the blacks, I feel like they look completely different. So it was a lot of fun, even though they looked so similar in colors. I feel like they're totally different. So hopefully you guys agree. But this is the lamp that I was talking about. I loved it in the gold color. It's so pretty and so industrial, and I just, yeah, had to use it. Here I'm just picking out some decorations and clutter items to put on the countertops. I didn't want to overly clutter it up, but I definitely wanted this build to feel lived in and fully decorated. So I do decorate the corner pieces over by the sink and the stove, but I leave the island part completely free, and I did play test it. The Sims seemed to be able to use everything without any problems. And then here I place this corkboard. I almost forgot what it was called, and I put some postcards on it. I thought that also looked really nice. It's one of my favorite things to do. I love the way it looks. And then here I'm just picking out some lights. These ones that I just placed up there in the loft area are with the pack. They came with the Moschino stuff pack. They are beautiful. I do wish that it would have came in maybe one other version that was a bit shorter, because they're kind of hard to use, at least on the shortest wall heights. I mean, you can size them down by hitting the left bracket key, but I'm not sure if it would still like probably block your Sims from being able to walk under them. So I use them in the open loft area because that was like the perfect spot. You know, Sims aren't going to walk underneath of them. So I was really happy to use them there, and I think they look so good and really industrial. Here I'm trying to find a couch. I kind of struggled with this. I ended up using this one that came from one of the updates when we got the Caribbean theme stuff. I really liked it a lot, and it wasn't my like initial like go-to or my initial thought of a more industrial style of furniture, and I don't think it necessarily looks that industrial, but it looks kind of funky, and I feel like a Sim that would live in an apartment like this would really appreciate the patterns and the kind of fun, like more fun style that these couches and chair have. I know we got some new furniture with the Moschino stuff pack, but they're a little bit more sleek and modern looking, and I didn't think it necessarily suited the style that I was going for. So yeah, I thought these ones worked perfectly. And then here I was picking out some art and a rug. I thought those leaning art pieces that came with one of the new updates a few months ago, I forget exactly when it came out, but it came with a freelancer career. I thought that looked really nice in there, and it looks, I think it suits the build really well. And then I also placed that black and white painting in front of the staircase. I think that also looked really nice in here. And the fireplace came from Vintage Glamour, and at first when I went to place it, I wasn't sure if it was going to actually fit the style for the build, but I think it totally works, especially in the black. It looks like it used to be like an older, it looks like it's been painted over. Like, I feel like it used to maybe not really suit this style, but the Sim painted it black just to match their taste. I don't know if that makes sense, but it's kind of something I was thinking about, but wasn't really my main focus. But over here behind the couch, I wanted there to be kind of like a little reading corner, and I wanted to use this new bookcase that we got with the pack as well. This is another item that I think is really nice, and the same thing that I said in my overview, I wish that plant with the trailing vine or whatever you call it, I wish that was a separate item. That is something that I would use over and over and over, probably in every single build, and it's something that I would really like. I have like four of those types of plants in my house. I have this pothos that I have propagated, and I have more propagations in my windowsill in my kitchen, and I'm just trying to spread them over my entire house, and that's how I want my Sims homes to be. So please, Sims team, if you ever happen to watch this video, I would absolutely love a plant like that. Please, please, please. Not connected to another object. Its own separate piece. That would be amazing. I also love the other decorations on it, like the leaning books, or I think somebody told me those were actually records. I'm not exactly sure, but either way, just those extra decorations would be so nice to have just separated so we could place them wherever we would like to. And I feel like with stuff packs, we should get more objects like that. Maybe that's just me, but I feel like it's supposed to be extra stuff. So in a stuff pack, I would like to see maybe more clutter stuff. But I don't know, I probably have a clutter problem, so maybe that's just me. But here I'm moving on to the upstairs. This is going to be their upstairs bathroom. So the downstairs bathroom did have a shower, and that really wasn't that necessary. I wasn't originally planning on it, but it fit really well in the space, especially with that awkward empty space that I had next to the bookcase. I was trying to fill it in with a plant, but I couldn't find one that I really wanted to use in that space. And I didn't want to overly put plants in this build. I didn't feel like it was too appropriate to make it filled with plants, even though I feel like it suits the style. I just probably do that way too often. So I wanted to use the space in a different way. And so I got to create the illusion of a brick pillar there. And I thought that looked really nice. But here I'm just cluttering up the bathroom counter. I used some debug objects, a bunch of makeup, and this blow dryer. I thought this turned out so nicely. It looks so realistic and nice and cluttered. And yeah, I thought this bathroom came together really nicely and has a bathtub in here. So if you do have a dog, or I don't know, you just have a Sim that likes to take baths, then you have the space to do that. And I thought this one actually looked really good because it looks like it's made of concrete. So it felt very industrial to me. I think it came from, I almost said Strangerville, but I think it is Jungle Adventure. For whatever reason, lately I've been getting those two packs mixed up when I start describing them in like a voiceover, and they're nothing alike, but I think that they're just both game packs and they came out relatively close to one another is the reason I am confusing them. So if I accidentally say that, because I know I've done that a few times and a few people have called me on it, then just ignore me. I know that certain things have, you know, not came with Strangerville or Jungle Adventure. I just, for whatever reason, cannot keep my words straight. But here I am decorating the bedroom area. This room would be like a dream. I think it'd be so cool just to have your bed like open to this lofty space. It's so cool. Like, I think it would be so much fun to live here. But I thought this bed that came from Seasons worked really nicely in this like goldy orange color, not orange, goldy yellow color. I thought that looked really pretty with the browns. And then I also get a computer desk up here and I use this one. I forget if it's base game or if it came with a pack, but it looks super industrial. And again, I used this metal chair with the wooden seat. And then I placed some art supplies, of course, because I did imagine that an artistic Sim would live here. Whether they do it for their career or their hobby, I'm not exactly sure, but I definitely want them to have an easel. I probably should have placed the digital drawing pad too, but I mean, if you play in this, you could of course just have your Sim keep that in their inventory. I also gave them a guitar, and I thought about using some of the music related equipment that came with the Moschino Stuff pack, like the amp and then that chest, whatever, I'm not sure what you call that chest, but it's like actually a coffee table in game. Thought about placing that, but then I don't know, decided against it, but it would definitely make nice clutter if you wanted to place those things in here. And then underneath the art easel, I placed that cardboard item that's actually a dance floor. I think that looks really good underneath the art easels because it looks like there's a little bit of paint splatter or some sort of markings and stuff on it. We do have a sheet that actually has actual paint splatter that definitely looks really good underneath art easels, but I think the cardboard looks a little bit more rustic, kind of industrial, so I felt like it suited the style so much better. Then here I'm just picking out some decorations to put on top of the dresser, some books and a few statues and plants. There I am moving this light. This light is really cool and I'm so happy that I remembered it because there's been a few different times where I've done industrial styles or builds that this would look nice in, and I've just completely forgotten about it. So yeah, really happy that I remembered it. It looks so good in here. And then I just placed a painting up above the bed, and then here I'm decorating the balcony. And for the balcony, I wanted it to look a little bit more industrial and rustic like the interior. So I used a couple of pillars and then used this exposed brick, but in this whitewashed version. And then I placed a few plants out here and a seating area, I think. I kind of forget exactly, but something I do remember, I placed all of these string lights and I used the ones that came from Toddler Stuff, I think is the pack. You'll see me place them here in just a moment, but a long time ago, I decorated this apartment and I did it in a very kind of light, bohemian, eclectic style. And that was one of my most favorite apartments. And one of my favorite things that I did was I used these string lights and draped them across the balcony. And I thought it looked so good. And I was like so proud of it when I did it. And yeah, when I was decorating this, I remembered it and I was like, I have to do it here. But here I'm just fiddling with this area. I end up using these couches. That's right. These ones I thought looked really nice, and I put them over here in kind of this L-shaped sectional form, and I think it looks really good. I put a coffee table here. I think a couple more chairs, an outdoor dining table. I do think I forgot to put a barbecue back here, so you may want a barbecue if you have any Sims that like to do that. And I use this round dining table again, the same as I did in my last apartment renovation, but I think it suits this build perfectly. And thankfully, this balcony was not being glitchy. The last apartment across the hallway from this one, that apartment balcony was being so glitchy and like I couldn't place anything on it. But thankfully, this one worked just fine. And yeah, I was able to fully decorate it without any issues. So I think it looks so much better. And then here I did replace these chairs for these ones that came with Island Living. I thought they looked so nice out here. And then I placed that tapestry behind the couch. I thought that also looked really good. But here I'm going in and starting to place the lights around. And I just absolutely love this. Like I said, I loved it so much the last time I did it that I had to do it here too. And so happy that I did. I think this would be such a cool spot to hang out if you were playing in this build or if it was a real house in real life. But we are coming up on the screenshots, so hopefully you guys have enjoyed this apartment and hopefully you guys do enjoy the screenshots. So thank you so much for watching, and please leave any comments or suggestions that you have, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye!
Need something to